Red alert, boys, red alert. Okay, so the TikTok detectives have been on the case, and I have seen a few videos that suggest something very, very interesting about the One Piece live action adaptation. So, okay, in the intro, we have Roger's execution. Like in Chapter Zero, we see a lot of guys that will become warlords watching the execution, right? Along with Shanks and also Baby Smoker, because we see that in the anime. Not in the manga, but in the anime. There is a woman that they flash to in the live-action adaptation who is standing in front of a younger Shanks. People have been saying that this might be Crocodile. I know that sounds insane, but remember, there's that whole bit that we see in Impel Down in the manga and in the anime, in which Emporio Ivankov says that he has some dirt on Crocodile. He knows a little something about his past. Many have thought for like, what, going on, how many years has it been? Has it been like 10 years now? I think it's been like 10 years. That came out like 2010 or something. So for like 10 years plus, people have always thought that Crocodile most likely used to be a woman. And I'm not going to lie to you. The woman whom they focus on for a few seconds, which is really weird. She could be Crocodile. And people bring up like, well, why doesn't she have the scar? Crocodile at that point doesn't necessarily need to have the scar, because remember in Chapter Zero, when we see this, Gecko Moria is skinny. This is before Gecko Moria fought Kaido. So many a thing have not happened yet. And we see a young Dracula Mihawk as well. So just like in Chapter Zero, we see an execution there. So brother, I don't know, because they kind of did a lot, and I'll give them this. They did do a lot with this scene, and I've done a whole video on the One Piece live adaptation on my YouTube channel. Go check that out. It's over an hour long, but yeah, this could be Crocodile. It could be, because why would you focus on a random woman for such a long period of time and then just go to Shanks? It's weird. I can see where people are coming from. One thing that's not seen is Buggy. Buggy's not in there, which is kind of weird. But the fact that that might be Crocodile is flooring me right now, because it's a possibility. It's a strong possibility. And seeing as how where we're at in the manga right now, this is going to come to a head sooner rather than later, because based on some developments that we've seen. So, oh boy, this could be real. This actually could be real. This random woman actually could be Crocodile. Oh my God. It could be. It actually could be. We only see the back of Crocodile's head in Chapter Zero. And I mean, you could change the costume however you want in the live action adaptation. They've taken many a liberty so far, which is, concerning, but whatever. This could actually be Crocodile. It actually could be Crocodile. And the hook is not a sticking point either, because we don't know when Crocodile got the hook. We actually don't know. We don't even know who cut Crocodile's hand off. We don't know. Many have theorized over the years that it's possible that it could be Whitebeard due to Crocodile having a vendetta of some sort against Whitebeard. And we see this all throughout the Marineford arc. So it's possible, but none of that matters at this execution, because this could even be before Ivankov met Crocodile. Like, we don't know. Crocodile, despite being one of the first major big bosses in the series, still has a very large shroud of mystery behind his backstory, and we've only gotten bits and pieces over the years. Mind you, this character is almost as old as the series itself, because I believe Alabasta took place in like 2000 or something like that. So yeah. Wow. That's a lot to process, but I think the TikTok detectives are onto something. I think this could be an allure to what's to come in the manga and anime, because It's weird. It's weird. And she looks too distinct to be a random person in the crowd. You know, and then to be a random person in the crowd is weird that they even focus on her for the length of time that they do. Mind you, it's only a couple of seconds, but still, to get a clear shot of her and for her to have such a distinct look is interesting. It's interesting because she's kind of given the same treatment as Shanks and Mihawk and Smoker. So it's weird. It's weird. That's all I have to say. Give me your thoughts, though.